It is a statement that is expected to rattle the job market. TDRCS ordering for an audit and regularization of all work permits issued in the country. This aimed at riding Kenya off illegal immigrants and those holding positions that could equally be held by Kenyans.
There are people doing jobs that Kenyans can do. And they have come in through back doors, through windows, and they have obtained what they purport to be work permits, but they're not work permits.
According to Matiangi, the Immigration Department records show approximately 34,000 foreigners legally in the country with certified work permits, but the number skyrockets in the job market with over 100,000 foreigners employed in the country. Consequently, all expatriates in the country have been issued with a 2-month notice to regularize their work documents by the state.
After 60 days, Mr. Kinoti will conduct a swoop and we will remove from our country people who do not desire to be here. And we are going to tighten. The process of work permits is changing radically beginning now.
This process, the government, however, says will not involve those attached to mission hospitals, universities, and select farms.
Give me one reason why we would give a work permit to someone who's coming to be an accountant in Kenya. An accountant in a country like ours. Or in the case of civil society, tell me why we would give a work permit to a program officer with the number of graduates we have who have masters and so on and so forth. Then we are giving a foreigner a work permit to work in Kenya as a program officer in a civil society organization.
Matiangi further says his ministry will keep a digital register to monitor expatriates working in the country based on their location and nature of jobs. This move, other critics have indicated, is a subtle purge as a follow-up to a crackdown late last year by the NGO's coordination board. Stephen Leto, Citizen Weekend.